engineers.
All right, train school. So normally, as we say, coffee is 6:30 in the morning, 7 o'clock, we're already setting up the fire escape. Today, we're over here, and not over there, because even though that needs to be finished, I need this, for the sunny day, to be the school. Today's not work, today's school. We're going to work, no matter what. Work is going to come anyway. But if we don't capture the school, part of this, why that black mat, why the bucket, why the table, why the paint station, why the lift that I'm going to bring, why the elevator to bring stuff up and down, why the electric, if we don't explain why, then that's, otherwise people will show up here, they'll bring that, they'll start with that, and that's all they have. But those things are going to fall, and they're going to break. Those things are going to fall, and they're going to break a window. Those things are going to fall and smash a window, which I pay. But if you have gray boxes, and you have buckets, and you have the inserts for the paint station, everything here is a Y. You copy the Y, percentage. If you don't copy the Y, we don't care. Then it's just money. I only pay so much for this stair and this tray, and that's all you're going to get. So vendors that come in, and they're going to work with us, the vendors have two choices. Dunkin' Donuts, or they can do regular coffee. This Dunkin' Donuts, where's the other cup? Anybody got, what's the double cup?
The white cup?
Yeah, well, in the dress. Somebody just pull it out for a second. Is it like crushed or?
It's right there in the trash bag.
Alright, so this is the difference. This is the difference between $3 and $1. Yeah? Same cup. Same cup. The cup is the same. Same company. Same. $1, $3. What's the difference? This one here is different than this one, but same material. This one says who they are and who they represent. And so you fill this cup full of shit, and somebody will call Dunkin' Donuts and say, hey, I was in a store in Rhode Island, and somebody gave me a Dunkin' Donut cup full of shit. You fill this with shit, and we go,
fire escape engineers.
You won't even go back to the place.
Yeah.
They give me my dollar. You fill this full of shit, you go back to Dunkin' Donuts and say, hey, I paid $3, you gave me a...
Oh, we're here. I actually think I saw them standing on the corner looking at me, but they never walked over.
So
we're on the fire escape, man. All the tops. I don't know how they didn't see us. We're right on the corner. Like, there's tops out, ladders.
All these things cost money.
Yeah.
That's who we are. We're Dunkin' Donuts.
Planks, ladders, tops out. Guys on the street, we're all out here. I mean, I don't see how they could have missed us. It's a big church and a school.
Comes by and sees our job and says, oh my God, these guys are hanging all over the place. You know what I'm saying? That's going to be a problem. So we are not this, we are this. Okay? So every now and then, you're going to see, he's the San Francisco guy. But this guy is all the way out from San Francisco. He wants to represent San Francisco, and he's been in the fire protection industry.
Yeah, was that them in front of the bodega? I don't know. They were just standing there. I didn't know if it was them or not. And then they left, so I assumed it wasn't. It was just some other guys looking for, you know, waiting for somebody.
Because the only way, because
you know, it's a busy corner there. I don't know if they were with you or not, but they were staring at us. I don't know if it was them. All right. Send them back.
Somewhere closer. You understand? So with that now, we have a system here. We have a system here just like McDonald's. To make fries, the fry guy. To make burgers, there's a burger guy. And to make cashier, we have a cashier guy. So there's a bottom guy who gives you anything you want. There's a middle guy who gives anything he wants, the bottom guy gives. offensive guy. He's the guy that's up in the tree. He's doing the hardest work. He's the smartest guy you got. He's the biggest structural guy you got, and he's all harnessed up, and he's up there, and he's doing the hardest job. He doesn't do easy jobs. He does only the hard job. He spends all day in the tree because he gets the most money. Got it? And up there, when he's done breaking the bolt, drilling the thing, we send him up a paint bucket. You know what he does? The most expensive guy I got, why do I make him paint underneath that platform over there? If he does bolts, you know, why do you think I have my most expensive guy? Why do we give him a paintbrush?
It's still the hardest spot to paint.
It's the hardest spot to paint. And you don't want to send just anybody up there to paint.
Mm-hmm.
So the bottom guy paints anything and everything while he's down here. So while he's down here, he'll be changing some bolts. So who changes these bolts down here? The top guy, the middle guy, or the ground guy?
Ground guy.
Yeah. Dude, I'd say middle guy.
If I need you to know all the fucking answers, I'll call you.
I just caught up in the moment.
You just caught up in the moment. All right, you understand? So there's a theory. The bottom guy got to give everybody everything. The bottom guy is running around. He's mixing paint. He's giving bolts. He's giving water. So when he's got nothing to do, what's he do? He changes these stupid bolts down here. Why? Because they're down here. The bottom guy is usually the newest guy. Keep an eye on the camera. Make sure we're getting recorded.
Yep.
Right. He's the youngest guy. So you don't want him up there yet. But you want him to learn how to use the grinder. And when he's down here, he's got the impact gun, so he's got all these bolts to do. What do you think he's going to do? Use the impact gun on all of them? Or is he going to do one tread with the impact gun? One tread with a grinder? One tread with a chisel? Right? If he's got railing, he's going to do the same thing. You got it? So that's how the training process. Before he can climb up, he's got to do all the dirty work. He's going to be tired. The ground guy is the most tired guy. He's also scraping. He's always scraping. That's why you have to be a paint master. So the paint master scrapes fire escapes, paints fire escapes, and gives you everything you need up to the two guys. Every job is three guys. You can have four guys, five guys, because today we have two more labor-ready guys coming. What do you think they're going to do? You think they're going to be over here? You think they're going to be over there in the middle? You think they're going to be at the top? Or you think they're going to have a scraper in their hand, they're going to fucking scrape this whole job down? And if they're in your way, where do they go? Somewhere else.
Out of the way.
And they just scrape. And when they finish scraping, what do you give them? What do they have right next to them besides scraping? A paint station. What do you do with a paint station?
Paint.
They'll be
out of our way.
And painting. So they do a section, go back and paint it. They'll do another section, go back and paint it. Because they always have scrapers inside that paint station. Is wire brush, scrapers. Everything they're gonna need. Got it? So all this while supporting the ground guy supports the second guy and the top guy. Today we're gonna purposely set up the lift and the pick to do this dangerous spot right there. That's probably the most dangerous spot. That's too dangerous for a pick. But we're gonna have to go to I'm gonna go today right to U-Haul. I mean not U-Haul, Home Depot. I'm going to drag a 35 footer or a 55 footer electric, put it on the sidewalk, lift, and we're going to have that for one day. It's $400. But in one day, and guess who goes inside that lift?
Top guy.
The bottom guy?
No.
The middle guy or the top guy?
Top guy.
Top guy. And guess what he's going to do all day?
He's up there.
Change bolts, and he's going to paint all day. Change bolts and paint all day. Why? Because it's a very special machine. Only smart people play the machine. And the guy underneath, he doesn't come down for nothing. All day long, he's up in the tree. Why? Because there's a theory here. Now, this is Dunkin' Donuts. This is McDonald's. Fry guy. Burger guy. Cashier. We also call it paint master. Nurse. Doctor. Doesn't matter. Okay? So, as I now ask him a question about this, translate some of that conversation that I just had before. So now, Nick.
You can talk to me, but so what did you just learn here in this whole station?
You got a system in play.
Yeah.
Follow it through.
Right. Well, tell me just in play. Tell me what's the paint master's position, which I've sent you videos, right?
Yeah.
So all that is recorded endlessly in 10 hours worth of video. You can either watch all 10 hours and finally get it, or you can watch 1 hour and finally get it. Because as soon as you can theorize it back to me, but then also follow the strategy, what happens? So do you want the fry guy wandering around in the burgers?
No.
Can he grow into the burgers? Where does he start?
Bottom, the fry guy.
With the fry guy. He's down here at the bottom. What's the middle guy do?
Step up. He's the next person in line.
Yeah, but where is he? Where do you want him to be?
Doing the bolts and the painting at certain areas up there.
He's only bolts.
Just strictly bolts?
Yeah, because he's got somebody else for painting.
Okay.
So he's on top. He's working the top of the fire escape. And so he's changing as many bolts as he wants. Excuse me, on top of the fire escape. And if the doctor calls, who's going to help him when the doctor calls for a scalpel? Yeah, but who knows where the scalpels are?
Well, the bottom guy, probably middle guy.
Middle guy, in case the bottom guy doesn't know. And every now and then there's some assistance needed up there for the doctor, and who's going to help the doctor, perform a critical surgery on a structural piece? Middle guy. So that's why it's important that we keep the small guy down here at all times. You know what I'm saying? Because there's a system. Today, we're not back at the other one for a purpose. It's a beautiful day. This is an opportunity for us to pull all our stuff out, set up, start, bring in some extra help, and bring in a lift. Great recording opportunity. Because from here, you can listen to all the conversations that are going on and see theory and practice. Okay? What else did you learn in my conversation about electrical and about, setup? What did you find?
He broke it down as far as how we do it. Every 9-10 feet, we want power. That's how we ran the cords all the way
right
down the skate.
And why clips? Why don't we use zip ties?
Out of the way so we can move them around easily.
Move around easily. Simple stuff. Yeah, relocation is easy. Why these buckets?
Keep everything organized, compact. Yeah.
Hey, Jay, can you bring out a red? One of those red stations? Sorry. Yeah. Okay, good. Grab this again. Hey.
Well, we have an elevator, but with that now that you understand the theory, that's the most important part is every time we get to a job site, we get here at 7 o'clock. When do we start working?
7?
8. It's going to take you 1 hour to get it all set up.
Oh, set it.
Once you get it all set up, and if I have this whole station in the back of a U-Haul truck, this I have to break down at the end of the day. I'm going to lose 1 hour breaking it all down, putting it into a trailer. Tomorrow, all over again, start. But sometimes I put this inside a U-Haul trailer. What's better, a U-Haul trailer, a U-Haul truck, all set up every day, you just close the door, or this? What's better? So not always do we have the truck, but whenever you want to, you can always set up the truck, and it's much faster. You gain. You can start up in half an hour. When you get here, the electric, we're going to set up the electric. You take it down every day, or you leave it up? Because that's already done. So in case it rains, yes, you have to be careful.
Inside loop, you have to connect that.
Yeah.
The line all the way in the south.
And he had a question about wetness. Do we have Ziploc? Do we have zip bags? Do we have any plastic that we can put any of the connectors that we're concerned about? Can we put them in a Ziploc? Or can we put them in a trash bag and then close it up temporarily for the rain? Because it's going to rain real hard tonight. Can we just put plastic over the things and close it? And then tomorrow, just take the plastic off? The other thing that's missing here that we have inside is radio. Why do you need a radio?
It's easy to communicate from the ground at the top.
Right, so down here normally you have a small little walkie-talkie because the doctor... And what happens if we have a generator over here?
You ain't gonna hear nothing.
Right.
We got a radio. Hey, I need some stuff.
Yeah. So with that, you have... This is going to have it set up, but now this needs electrification, so this is missing. Now let's talk about one of the buckets. Bring one of the buckets over here, and let's start off with the paint bucket. Actually, give me the red and give me the red, and then set up a real paint station if you could with a scraper, the, you know, just one of them. Need all three. Come in closer, man. Anybody have any idea why you need three? Why don't you take a whack at it, Nick? Why do you think you need all three?
Organization still. You can keep everything together and with you at all times. You don't want to be going up and down or having other people go up and down for you if you don't need to.
That's true. So organization is the first reason why the doctor and the nurse, this is their setup all the time. How do you send this up? I want to send this up to the top floor. Do you go up the stairs?
No, I'll pull it up.
Or do you... close it, wrap it, and you have the elevator already up there?
Yeah, we got one set up.
We'll use that elevator. So we have a rope, we lock it, and we send it up. At the end of the day, we're closing the job. What do we do with the bucks? Come down the
send
stairs.
Them back down.
The elevator, put everything down. So now, there's a reason. Now this is all on videos already. Hundreds of hours of video. And this is another video. You want to prove to me you know your shit? You'll be doing these videos. With new people coming aboard. You want to prove you know your shit? You're going to do a video of people. You can even do one of these in Portuguese if you want. But until you do a video, until you listen to it, write it, and then record it, you don't know this. Because this you have to repeat every day. So today, look, beautiful sunshine. We should be working, we should be breaking bolts. No. We should be learning. Because what you learn today, you're going to use forever. If you don't learn this today, what happens is tomorrow is a different day. It's a different box. It's a different tool. It's a different way. We don't work on the ground. Monkeys work on the ground. We don't work on the ground. You have a tool up there, it goes in a bucket. It never goes on the ground. You have bolts, it goes in a bucket. You have paint, it goes in a bucket. You have trash, it goes in a bucket. You have water, it goes in a bucket. You have a cup of coffee, put it in your bucket. And everything over there is tied. Over here, you know what I'm saying? You gotta tie up. Not tie over here.
Yeah.
Called tie up. Everything gets two ties, you know, two knots, right? Up there, because something's gonna happen. And it's not the guy up there that says, I'm sorry, it's the guy down here
getting
a bunch of fucking screws on his head. So there's a reason why we tie this up. Even if it's paint, there's a reason why we tie this up. Same exact thing.
Your cup in a bucket.
You know, same exact reason here, right? Always tie up. Don't tie sideways. Somebody's always gonna. And that one little piece can hold the paint inside. Because the paint on this wall cost me thousands of dollars. It cost you your job. Because they look, oh, I'm sorry. So I don't give a fuck if you're sorry. That's $1,000. You can say sorry or you can clean it for free. Or take money out of your paycheck, you know, because the rule is you put it up. So when the bucket gets kicked over full of paint and you didn't tie it up, you have a choice. Pay for it, or you pay with your job. Pay with money, or pay with your job. Either way, I'll take you the payment. But if you're gonna give me an excuse, you know, that you don't have to pay for the wall, when the rule is you gotta, everything gets tied up, then you broke the rule. So I'll pay for it, but you know, I'll give you a free ride. Where you wanna go? I'll get Uber for you. You going home? Where are you going? But don't come back tomorrow. I need you tomorrow. Gentlemen. Two knots, always. Loose. Don't have to be crazy knots, you know, two knots. Right. A lot of times when you go, feel how heavy this is.
Yeah, I'm just moving stuff.
No, no, it's heavy. I know, feel it. Heavy, right? Okay. So when we send this up to the top, it goes in here. Okay? But as soon as I'm ready to start working, this is the only one I need. As soon as I start working, this is all I need. That stays up there somewhere. And even then I can still put this inside here. Right then I can still put this inside there. Because every now and then you have too much shit in the red thing. These cars, these are more expensive than those things. Those are $2, $3. These are $10, $12 a piece. But there's a reason, because when you work, I want my grill on this side and I want my bolts on this side. Done. Got it? And I always have an extra bucket. There's always a bucket up there. So even though I work primarily with these two, every now and then, I have to go do a job on the treads, or I gotta do a job, and this doesn't work anymore. But because I always have three, that's all I need. So take this with you down the treads. Take this with you to the support. Take this with you. So a doctor who doesn't have a gray, a red, and an orange with him all the time, he's not a doctor. He's a janitor. Okay? It's very important. Explain to me in Portuguese. Nick, what you learn? Come over here closer. Explain that to me. Back it up.
Get everything up there and be ready. Have your setup up there. Oh, I forgot something. Come back down or have something set us up. And pretty much actually it's a good system. You can have that one stored over there. Bring what you need, bring over here. Oh, okay, you got your other stuff right there. Grab it, fill your red bucket up, bring it. Everything's just readily available for you.
Right. So if you're a doctor or a nurse, you don't have your three, how are you working? You call your janitor. You're a janitor. Got it? And the guy that keeps control of all the pieces down here is the paint master. Because there's going to be a lot of debris, a lot of sweeping, a lot of setup. I'm missing a bolt. I need some more paint. The paint master runs his ass off down here. But then he gets to practice a lot. Okay? Jay, we got a paint station that I can show? Clip, rag, cup. As you can see, sometimes the language has to be Spanish or Portuguese. Right now we're doing it in Portuguese. All right, Nick. Grab back. Camera.
I'm over here. Nice. We're going to do painting now, so. Paint? Hey, this is never for paint.
Yeah.
You may have a spray paint in there, but never paint. This is a paint station. Watch. We're putting together a paint station right now. we created this paint station to be like a dog. Nobody else does this. Nobody does this. So our paint station starts exactly the way. Do you have a little clamp?
Yeah.
Need a wire brush? Brush to be a, give me a broom, a little baby broom. We got the safety glasses, this one right there. The baby broom. It's a big, big four inch. Okay, are you guys ready? So the paint master sets these up all the time. We got five guys coming, he sets up five stations. There's always three stations all the time, ready to go, always. There's always a station down here, and when this guy's got nothing to do with the paint master, he's painting, because he's got his paint station ready all day, 1 inch of paint, ready. In the middle of the job, there's always a paint station ready to go. Why? Because when the nurse is waiting for a drill or waiting for a bolt, the nurse paints all day. The nurse's job is to break bolts, but then every now and then you're waiting for something. You don't wait for nothing. You paint everything. Because the nurse has a station. The doctor has a paint station. Because every now and then he's up there doing something. There's a paint station at the very top. So there's a paint station down here, and I can do anything I want over here. Paint station in the middle, and a paint station at the end. And the doctor says, I need a paintbrush. So grab the whole paint station, give it to the doctor. He does whatever he has to do. He gives you back the paint station, and you tie it up there. And you tie it up. And whenever you need paint, the paint station don't come downstairs. You set up one of these fillers with 1 inch of paint, not 2 inches, not 3 inches, 1 inch, because people will drop paint. And when they drop paint, then they will drop paint because they didn't tie off the bucket. Guess where it lands? It lands on your blue tarps. And if you're doing multiple floors, what do you think these black mats are for? Are these mats put down here, or are these mats up above?
On floors.
When you're doing five floors, these mats, because you lay them on the floors, and every now and then bolts drop, paint drops, and you stop the paint from going five floors. You only drop one floor. Paint station. You guys ready? In the paint station. Come in closer. What's this for?
Clean up.
Clean up, because they're going to make a mess. What's this for?
Cleaning. Wire, rust.
Right? Yeah. Rust. What's this for?
Scraping old paint, rust.
Old paint. What's this for?
Touch up.
Some things that are too difficult to paint,
yep.
You have to use spray. What's this for?
Painting.
Nope, it's a brush. It's a broom.
Oh, really? Okay.
So don't use 4 inches to paint fire escapes. We use 2 inch. We have the 2 inch, okay? What's this for?
Ceiling around any place water can get in.
The paint is gonna caulk all day. Paint, caulk. Or sometimes caulk, then paint. Set up. What's this for?
What's that? Oh, storage.
For paint. Put it here, or you put it over here?
Yeah.
Okay? This usually gets clipped together. Okay? Because you make a mistake,